anchor your life to the inspiring words that will put a rainbow in your sky. Listen to Word and Songs, a program that will introduce you to the Word of Life and beautiful music to help you experience peace and consolation. Join the Daughters of St. Paul for half an hour of Word and Songs.
Hello, dear friends! Happy Ascension of the Lord's Sunday to all of you! Your friend, Sister May Ann of the Daughters of St. Paul, invites you to keep me company in our weekly program, Word and Songs. As we draw closer to the end of May, a month dedicated to Mary, and a month when, in this time of COVID-19 pandemic crisis, we and the entire nation were consecrated to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, on the Feast of Our Lady of Fatima on May 13. It is good to think of ways how to unwind ourselves from the day's activities. It can be a moment of relaxation or watching online or television programs, spending time with children, relatives, or dear friends. But how about taking a moment to thank the day by counting all the blessings we receive from the Lord, be it small or big? And even we are in the midst of COVID-19 pandemic crisis, the more we are in need of God's intervention. I now invite you to cherish words of inspiration as you sit back and relax and join me in this 30-minute program, Word and Songs.
Says I see.
Yes, the power of God's love is greater than the darkest times of human survival. For God will surely make a way. Friends, it's been almost 4 months now since the news of coronavirus 2019 exploded and has affected the world at large. In the Philippines, it's almost 10 weeks already since Metro Manila locked down for enhanced community quarantine. We cannot avoid worrying of an uncertain future, like members of the family that can possibly be infected by the virus. The pain of leaving a deceased family member to die alone, the agony of hunger, jobs at risk due to lockdown, poor families survived by day-to-day earnings from hard labor. Pope Francis, in his 54th World Communications Day message, urged us that times like this, we should not be indifferent from people's suffering, but rather be united with them. The Pope said, "Indifference, self-centeredness, division, and forgetfulness are not words we want to hear at this time. That is to say, we need to hear words and stories of hope as one way of showing compassion and solidarity. We do believe that God will make a way in His ways, in His time."
Oh,
The message of today's 54th World Communications Day reminds us that good and transformative stories possess power that can generate change and nourishes people's lives. In fact, from childhood or even from the womb, stories are already heard by babies as mother tells stories either from fairy tales, films, telenovela, news reports, and many others. Like food, we hunger for stories. It influences our thinking, our behavior, and our principles in life. However, not all stories are good. There are stories that are unconstructive and provocative. They exploit, mislead, distort, destroy, and break persons' and people's dignity. To reject unverified and false information and stories, we need wisdom and critical thinking to be able to create, welcome, and discern true and false stories. In this time of pandemic crisis, we need to listen to messages of hope and consolation to lift people from disheartening situation. To deepen today's reflection, we need to listen more to the Pope's wisdom of communicating life-giving stories that transforms and nurtures life after this song.
When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise your shoulders, you raise me up to more than I can be. Shoulders, You raise me up to more than I can be.
Such a beautiful and inspiring song from Westlife, reminding us of God's abiding presence that gives us strength to raise us up and face difficulties and uncertainties caused by COVID-19 with hope, faith, and courage. You're tuned in to Word and Songs, and this is still your friend, Sister May Ann of the Daughters of St. Paul, sharing with you insightful reflection about communicating hope in time of pandemic crisis. My friends, stories that can uplift the desperate and renew life are gospel-based stories. This is why Pope Francis, in his message for the 54th celebration of World Communications Day, emphasized that communication must connect good memory with life through stories. The Pope recalls how Jesus used parables to communicate the power of his message about the kingdom of God so that his listeners can easily relate, grasp, and understand his message and leave them a room to think, reflect, and apply his message in their lives. The Bible is a love story of stories. God himself is the one narrating to us in calling things into life that culminates in the creation of man and woman to freely collaborate with him in building his kingdom on earth with Jesus, his only son, as the fulfillment and incarnation of that love. We need to tell the world of that love. We need to tell the world of God's love.
Jesus Christ, our Savior, His most precious one. He has sent us His message of love and sent those who search the world for those who have won.
friends, the Bible story is the best communication of God to us and the best of all communications. The stories of the lives of saints and martyrs are also testimonies of love communicated to all people of all time. The theme of the Pope's message for this year's World Communications Day reminds us that every story is born out of life, from interrelating with others. This means communication is therefore called to connect memory with life through stories that builds, uplifts, inspires, and brings change in people's hearts. A story that brings hope. There is so much to share, my friends, but this is all for now, and I thank you for keeping me company for half an hour of word and songs. At this point, I'd like to acknowledge and thank the source of my sharing, from Pope Francis' message for the 54th World Communications Day, entitled, "That You May Tell Your Children and Grandchildren, Life Becomes History," published in zenit.org. And thanks also to vaticannews.va, the basis of some of my insights pointing to the heart of the Pope's message this year. Likewise, special thanks to all the composers, producers, and artists of the songs we featured in this program. "Power of Your Love" by Hillsong, "In His Time" by Maranatha Music, "You Raise Me Up" by Westlife, "Tell the World of His Love" by Jamie Rivera, and "Heal the World" by Michael Jackson for our final song. Thank you very much. May you continue to inspire the world with your gift of music. And may your music always communicate the love of God to His people. To those of you who follow us on YouTube and Facebook, thank you for listening. Remember, Pauline's Radio PH is linking lives and healing hearts. And if you're searching for spiritual books and media materials that would help enrich your spiritual life, do visit any Pauline's Media Center nearest you, or visit our website, www.store.paulines.ph. This is Sister May Ann Padilla of the Daughters of St. Paul, saying bye for now and hoping that with Mary, who needed Jesus, the divine word, in her womb, we count all our blessings received from God despite the crisis we are facing as a nation and as a world. We must be determined to tell stories of love and hope as Jesus did to us, so that we can bring healing to the wounded world in this time of crisis. Join me again next week for another episode of Word and Songs. God bless us all.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place was brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space, make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you. Love that cannot lie. Love is strong. It only cares for joyful giving. If we try, we shall see. In this bliss we cannot feel. There are dreams. Stop existing and start living. Then it feels that always love's enough for us growing. Better place for you and for me.
You've just heard Word and Songs. This program was brought to you by the Daughters of St. Paul.